Hello, this is Lucas Palmeira from Imaginando, and for this tutorial I'm going to show you how to incorporate VS Visual Synthesizer into your compositions in Bitwig. So let's get right into it. I've got three tracks here, which we can listen to now. A kick, a snare, and a hat. And now let's root this. First, what I'm going to do is group these tracks. I'm going to put them all inside this group. So we have all tracks here, and I'm going to rename it as audio. Okay, now first thing we have to do to root the notes to VS is to go here on Bitwig, a Bitwig device called in the category routing, and it's called note receiver. And on this note receiver, which I'm going to call for now kick, what we have to do is choose the note source to kick. So we have here the note source is kick, and as well here instead of master, we connect it to VS, which I'm going to open right now. So Imaginando, VS, okay, and here we have VS. So now I go back to kick, and here I send it to tracks VS. Okay, so right now, as you can see, I already have the kick playing. Now let's route the other channel. So I'm going to put another receiver here, which I'm going to put here and change the name to snare. And again, note source has to be snare, and send it instead of master to tracks VS. Now, for as default, this note receiver sends the MIDI messages to channel 1. So what I have to do is add another device called channel map, in which the first channel is going to be routed to channel 2. So now, if I play it, it's being sent to channel 2. So if I go here, channel 2 on VS, enable our layer, let me choose a layer for this, trigger MIDI, and as you can see, it's being triggered by our snare. So let's do the last one. Again, note receiver, I'm gonna call it hi-hats now, hi-hats, put it here. Now note source again, audio, hi-hats, and here on the output I put VS. Now again, I want it on channel 3, so I have to choose another channel map. And now here, as you can see, it's playing on channel 1, and I'm going to send it to channel 3. So now I go here and pick up another material, enable it, trigger MIDI, and change the channel to channel 3. So we have the three channels playing and being triggered on VS. So now I can grab all these the tracks of the note receiver and group them, so this gets more tidy. I'm gonna put them inside this group, and now I can call this group VS MIDI, and we've got everything clean. Now, finally, to route audio to VS, what we have to do is go to the audio group, and now we can send the track, the audio here, audio to tracks, and we choose VS. As you can hear, the volume is lower, but as soon as we get it to 0, because it's by default on minus 10, we get this about the same volume. I'm gonna put it on minus 0.1, it's perfect. So as you can see, we're already receiving the audio here. And now I can choose something else for this layer. I'm gonna choose this one, enable it. And I'm gonna take the brightness off, otherwise it's always on. You can see it being triggered already by the envelope generator, but I'm gonna take it out to zero. And what I wanted is being triggered by the envelope, the audio modulator. So it's here, brightness, and I'm gonna raise it to maximum. And as you can see, it's already being triggered. And I can also do something a little bit more drastic and increase the glow, for example, so you can feel it a little bit more, and the size. And as you can see, now we have three tracks that are being triggered by MIDI notes, and a fourth layer that it's being triggered by the audio of all the tracks. Quite simple, isn't it? And this was it, guys. I hope this was clear enough for you. We will be doing more tutorials like this for other DAWs. So remember to check that out. I will say goodbye for now, guys. Goodbye.